Edna Feber once said this. She said, perhaps too much of everything is as bad as too little. Sometimes we do have too much of everything. And then we kind of shrug our shoulders. It's a been there, done that type of attitude of mind. In Proverbs 16, verse 32, the Bible says this, moderation is better than muscle, self-control better than political power. Moderation and wisdom are traveling companions. And if we're wise, we'll learn to temper our appetites, our desires, and our lower human impulses. And when we do, we're going to be blessed. Blessed in profound ways, in part because God has created a world in which temperance is rewarded, and intemperance brings undesirable consequences. Well, would you like to improve your life? Of course you would. Then harness your appetites. Restrain your compulsions. Moderation to the human mind is sometimes difficult, and it is especially difficult in a society that constantly teaches us that more is better, but sometimes more isn't better. But the rewards of moderation are numerous, and they are long-standing. And choose to pursue those rewards today. When you live a life that is something that you don't need the outer things to give you satisfaction or happiness, or a constant feeding of those new items, where you're just happy. You just have it all already. That's true happiness. Now, no one can force you to moderate your appetite. The decision to live in a moderate way is yours, and it is yours alone. But, my friend, it's the wise way to live. It's the path to God's promised blessings. When we tend to want more and more and more to satisfy and to make us happy, really something is very empty and something's very lacking. And then we have to live a life to feed and to take care of those things. In the way of a bigger house requires a bigger house payment and so on and so forth. I pray that you are satisfied with less than you could have, that you have a feeling of happiness right now, that anything else you get is just dessert, that you are full right now with a nutritious meal of life. And then you'll find that you do not have less, but you'll have more. You'll have more friends, more wonderful loving relationships, more of everything in life that really matters, and you'll have the time to explore those things because you won't have the pressures of your possessions. God bless you, my friend. I wish you a life that is filled to the brim with satisfaction.